So in this lesson, we're going to look at the changing role of the nation state and challenges to national sovereignty. In the previous lesson, we've already considered how countries like the United Kingdom or indeed Belgium cannot purely be considered as sovereign states because they have a higher order of legal power above them in the form of the European Union. Further questions need to be asked about the United Nations, organisations like the IMF, the International Monetary Fund, the World Trade Organization, also the transnational corporations such as YouTube, Facebook, eBay are becoming increasingly powerful. To these and other things like trading blocs and economic unions really mean that the concept of national sovereignty is outmoded. So let's have a think about numbers. Warren Buffett, Carlos Slim, and Bill Gates put them together, and they would own more than the 57 poorest nations in the country. So those three people have more money than 57 countries. So this is quite an amazing fact when you think about the economic power of these organisations. One of these very large organisations, which has grown greatly recently, is of course Amazon. Have a watch of this video and make some notes. And all the time, think about the power of Amazon. Now, looking at this video, the British government, and specifically here, I think the Welsh government, are really very much, the opinion is that they are at the mercy of companies like Amazon. They're so desperate to get those jobs into the country. It's almost that Amazon is running the game and setting the rules and interpretation of the laws rather than the individual countries. So again, where is the role for the sovereign state within that framework? Also, something that you should focus on, because this is close to our part of the world, is the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Watch this video, definitely. It talks about goods, services and skilled labour and capital, and how ASEAN attempts to harmonise the economies of its 11 members and get more movement, a form of globalisation at a regional level. If you want, you can take a look at this cartoon. I hope you stopped the video and had a look at the YouTube videos. If you haven't, you need to go back and do that and make some notes. So we'll go back to this idea of hyperglobalists. You remember from previous lessons the theory of hyperglobalism, and that is that we are approaching a truly global age. What it says there is that it claims the world has entered a truly global age of capitalism and its globalisation, and those international organisations, or those organisations between countries that are becoming more popular. So here we're talking about a global market and free trade. They are again a threat to the national economy, or at least the sovereignty of the national of those national economies. Does it put the nation state as the primary unit of political organisation into question? So here, along with transnational corporations, we can really see an argument for a big shift from the power of the nation state to these international organisations such as transnational companies, and maybe even organisations such as ASEAN and the European Union and NAFTA. Points to think about: popular doom and gloom, people are going to get upset about this, knee-jerk reactions. There might actually be a lot of good things in the cooperation between countries. The nation state could actually become more important. Is their role, and you saw this in the Amazon video, is their role to attract transnational investment and jobs into their country? Certainly you saw that in the Amazon video with Wales trying to attract Welsh Amazon to come to Wales. Examples of this could be the special economic zones, China, and the free trade zones in South Korea. We've talked about those in previous videos. These are specific country-based strategies to get the transnational corporations in. So the nation state then becomes more of a role of enhancing the competitive advantage to attract those transnational corporations. Therefore, actually, the nation state becomes more important, not less important. So again, discuss the links between those diminishing effectiveness of political borders, flow in controlling that flow of goods, capital, labour, market and ideas. Think of those flows in both directions, but also think about the benefits that globalisation is bringing to those flows, both in and out of a country. Should the government then, rather than being thinking at a national level, which South Korea has very much done, should they be thinking at a cluster of countries, as they've done in the ASEAN nations? Now, you'll see in the video that ASEAN consists of 11 countries. They do talk about unity. They do talk about those countries working together for economic reasons and for social reasons and for peace reasons as well. So should the function of the modern nation state, should their focus be on working with blocks and clusters of countries rather than individually? The ASEAN is very clear. They feel that there is much more power when they get together. So we've got some videos here. Can you research for me, please, what a free trade area is, what customs unions are, and what common markets are, and economic unions? Please pause the video, do some research on these, and then turn me back on. I hope you've paused the video and made some notes. You might also want to watch this video. Just imagine what our life would be like without capitalism. This is what one American institution has said our life is likely to be like without capitalism. So we come back to this European Union. We've talked about that already in the context of the previous lessons, in the context of Belgium and the UK. You know, click the video, watch what the European Union is about. Think, does the European Union actually make irrelevant the sovereign status of its members? Has the European Union eroded sovereignty of the states? This is a very up-to-date and recent video. Click that link, watch the video, and make notes about the main concerns, whether or not the European Union has compromised the sovereignty of its member states. If you haven't done so already, please do go back to this page here and have a watch of the cartoon. It's actually quite funny. It's from way back in 2007, I believe. Have a watch of that. Okay, guys, we'll discuss these issues further. Please come to the lesson with your questions and your points of clarification.